by this time next year and probably earlier by the summer, we're going to be in a much better position. Vaccines should become widely available. We're going to feel a lot better about going out and about in public and going to work and socializing. So the key is now hanging on now for the next 4 or 5 months, where we're going to enter what may be the worst period during this epidemic. As bad as it's been, it's about to get worse, and that's based on projections about a fall-winter surge as people are indoors more. Institute for Health Metrics and Philadelphia projections showing a steep rise in the number of new cases and deaths, unfortunately. What I've been trying to explain to people is we'll get better, but we're going to go through a terrible period and get ready. And that means getting ready means identifying the family members or loved ones or friends that you want to social distance with over the next 4 or 5 months, create a unit that where you're not seeing a lot of outside people coming in. And it's better to do that than be alone during this period, because there's going to be a huge impact on mental health. You're going to get sad, you're going to get scared, you're going to get depressed. This is a normal response to a very stressful situation. And, you know, if the election goes against the president, as most people predict, we don't really know what the White House is going to be doing in terms of providing guidance or any kind of leadership in terms of controlling the pandemic. They haven't really been very involved in creating a national response to begin with. I can only imagine what it's like during that lame duck session.
Oof. Okay, so that's the reality. We are hitting the second wave hard. Not that we ever fully got out of the first wave, because the United States decided to be immensely reckless, led by Donald Trump and Republicans, in dealing with the coronavirus. We are over 215,000 deaths, closer to 220,000 deaths in the United States, but apparently those people don't count. Rudy Giuliani going on the stump saying people don't die of COVID-19 anymore. Well, that's not the reality. We are about to hit more mass deaths from the coronavirus, but because they're disproportionately poor and they don't have access to the treatment that was sent directly by the pharmaceutical manufacturers like Chris Christie and Donald Trump, or they don't matter, I guess, you know, to that administration. The mental health aspect, which was also touched on there, that's going to be extreme. We all have to hunker down, come up with things that are going to make us happy in these winter months, especially if you're like me and you're from the Northeast and it gets really dark and there's very little sunlight during the winter. And, you know, I'm saying this not to freak people out, but to say that we shouldn't go into this time period with any illusions of what's going to happen. There's going to be a lot more death from COVID-19. It is going to be a struggle personally for a lot of people. We've all been kind of experiencing some low-grade depression as we can't go outside and we haven't been able to do the social things that we want to, or I want to. I'm kind of somebody who likes to have a good time and socialize, right? So I totally get that. But independent of the personal here, we are likely not to get another stimulus until February because Congress can't get it together. The open secret is that Trump is going to lose, so Republicans aren't incentivized to accept the White House deal, and Pelosi isn't accepting the White House deal. We need both of those dominoes to fall for another stimulus to happen. I think it's egregious that Pelosi isn't doing so, but you guys know my stance on this. It's well documented. So that means on top of all of those things, the economic crunch that people are going to be under will be massive. As mass death is being experienced throughout the country, as we're experiencing a mental health crisis, we'll get through this together, but this is the reality. And don't let Republicans who are trying to have some sort of flowery vision of the country going into November 3rd let you believe otherwise. With coronavirus outbreaks picking up speed in dozens of states, the U.S. is now climbing steadily toward a new peak in cases that may soon rival the summer surge when the country hit more than 60,000 infections on average a day for weeks in a row. On Friday, U.S. cases surged higher than they had since late July, hitting nearly 70,000 in one day. The seven-day daily average is now more than 58,000 cases a day. As of Tuesday, new cases have gone up by more than 30% from 2 weeks ago. Last week, 17 states, primarily in the Midwest and Great Plains, posted new daily records according to the COVID Tracking Project. The outbreaks raging in the Midwest play a major role in the rising numbers, with 57% growth in daily new infections over the past 2 weeks. That region, defined as 12 states by the U.S. Census, accounted for more than a third of all new cases in the U.S. last week, according to NPR's analysis of CDC data. Hospitalizations also increased in more than 40 states, with the number of people currently hospitalized reaching more than 37,000, which is more than half the highs recorded during the spring and summer surges. Dr. Amesh Adalja of Johns Hopkins University Center for Health Security says more people congregating indoors, including students returning to schools, reopen the schools and college campuses, and general fatigue around pandemic precautions are likely propelling this latest growth in cases. Dr. Peter Hotez of Baylor College of Medicine says models forecasting upwards of 170,000 deaths in about the next 4 months, and Dr. Anthony Fauci's warnings that the U.S. could eventually surpass 100,000 cases a day may come to pass given the current trajectory of the pandemic. Things are about to get bad. Stay safe. Listen to the science, do wear a mask, limit where you're going, don't be in crowds, and just hang in there. We're all thinking of each other and sending love to everyone watching this. It's going to be okay.